us today and our amazing trustee Alonso who made this happen. I'd like to thank you all for coming and showing your support for what we're doing and for our partners in doing. It's been the most incredible 24 hours for us because yesterday morning we were part of the Paralympic Torch Relay. We had five relay participants, including Fred and Simeon, who made the talk this afternoon. And we have had an absolute explosion of interest from the media because of that. We've been all over the newspapers, the broadcast media as well. So it's been a real game changer for us being part of the Paralympics. And that's one of the reasons why we wanted to celebrate here this evening. So I'm not going to say any more at this stage. I'll say a few more words at the end. What I'm going to do now, assuming we're all mic'd up, is hand over to Fred. Fred is a very inspirational figure. He is the executive director of our partner, Andy, which works in Kenya with disabled youth on a whole host of issues. I was visiting Nairobi earlier this year and met Fred's team and saw the breadth of the work that they're doing. And one of their particular focuses is on sport and the role that sport has in promoting positive outcomes for disabled youth. So without any more ado, I'm just going to ask Fred to say a few words about what he's been doing here and what Andy does. Thanks very much.
Thank you so much for being here. Follow the scripture. My name, as you heard, is Frederick Oko, and I'm the Executive Director of Action Network for the Disabled, abbreviated as Andy. And our organization is founded by young people with disability, initially from the slums of Kibera, which maybe you have heard, or one of the largest slums in sub-Saharan Africa. With incredible challenges for everybody, but more challenging for any person with disability who lives within this space that doesn't have proper infrastructure. So our organization works around how do we provide opportunities for these particular young people who most of the time do not get the attention of policymakers, for instance, or huge development organizations because they might not have the capacity to come up with high-level projects to attract these huge organizations. And particularly, we've been interested on how do we facilitate opportunities through sports. How do we facilitate opportunities through economic empowerment, given that for any person, even if you have no disability, you have to worry about how you're going to get your next meal. And if any development work is going to continue without having that in mind, I can guarantee you, because I've done some work around Kenya, that it's headed nowhere. So we try to work around building the capacities of these particular young people to be able to fend for themselves, and by this, training in entrepreneurship and business skills. How do you make a business plan, and how do you source for funding, and in most of the time, which our project also supports them with initial startup capital, with them, they are able to implement the idea, and that turns back to help them have income, sustainable income, so that they don't necessarily continuously depend on us as an organization, because ours, we can only do that much. And doing all this and having the, because resources are difficult thing to come by, especially if you're working in development work and in a developing country, and you're working with a group that has been hugely marginalized, not only in Kenya, not only in Africa, but worldwide. Then you have to be careful about what you're proposing to people and what you strategize a way that will help people come out of poverty. And to find partners that you can work with and that understand that actually that's what needs to be changed, and you need to work alongside people, but not direct people on what to do, is one of the challenging things that I've found out. My few years in working in development work, especially in disability work in Kenya. And this brings me to the fact that we've been able to work and are actually working with AbleChildAfrica to ensure that there is a continuous way that we look at what are the problems facing young people with disabilities, say, in Kenya. And our projects, and one of our greatest projects together working with AbleChildAfrica is a sports for health, which generally is built around how do we create positive change within the community, this particular community, and by and large in Kenya, by instilling a sense of discipline, confidence, and skills in young people that they know by virtue of being a person with disability, that's not the end, but I can actually invest my time and use my talent towards earning a decent livelihood. And you'll be surprised the fruits that you can see from this particular small one single project that we are working on with AbleChildAfrica, which allows young people space, give them a platform to practice sports, and that would be wheelchair basketball, swimming, volleyball, and table tennis, and you get to understand that actually people lack opportunities for them to progress. And when you look at this, that from the hundreds of young people who work with, you have people who now can go and apply for jobs after getting tutored on how to write a CV, how to go through an interview and actually convince a potential employer that you can actually work than sitting in an office because you're a person with disability. It brings out that attitudinal change, both for employers and also the general community, because these particular participants come from communities, families, and when these families are able to see that our kid can bring something on the table while we did perhaps invest in him or her, thinking that that was the end by being a person having a disability, they place a difference, because within these families, we have people also working, say, in companies, and they begin to have conversations that then changes attitudes across the board, and we begin to see people being employed. And we also take quite a considerable time to talk to employers to make them understand that we need to provide opportunities, we need to employ people based on their skill and qualification, other than just looking at them having a disability. So, one simple way, for example, why we are here and why we come to London, I've never been to London, I've passed through Heathrow, but that actually is not London because that's an international space. But the reason I'm here is the one project that we implement with AbleChildAfrica, which I talked about, seeing somebody rise from a project beneficiary and really inspiring others to also come up as sportsmen and women, because she has already achieved. And if you will be watching television, I don't know which channel it will be, if you see somebody called Mary Nakumicha, you will then understand this story that I'm telling you, that this particular individual has worked with us in our project, has came into our project as a beneficiary, graduated, got the benefits of training, and now she's training other youngsters in table tennis, while she's going to be throwing javelin, and she's actually going to win. We are very sure that she's going to win a gold at the Paralympics. Mark my words, because there will be television that will be showing this. So we see how if you choose to invest in those talents and you provide these particular opportunities to people who are otherwise marginalized, there's a huge difference. And this is really why, I mean, I can talk on and on, why we like working with AbleChildAfrica, because when we told them that it's not going to be workshops that are going to deliver change to these young people, it's going to be meaningful projects that speak to them in their areas of talent. And when they say, yeah, we can work with you, and we actually started that work, one year and a half down the line on this particular project, we can actually mention to you particular names of people who are in government offices now working from our project. We can tell you people owning particular businesses in Nairobi from the work that we do with AbleChildAfrica. And it's really inspiring how people never know that sports can actually create change. And I believe if you want to know more why we think that sports makes a huge difference to the lives of persons with disability, there is a possibility of interacting with AbleChildAfrica and us just to really know how exactly this is being done and why we are in London now, because of that particular aspect that we chose to empower persons with disability in Kenya. Thank you for listening.